Good morning, students. Now I am going to explain one important concept which is useful for coming examination with respect to financial management theory. One small concept, the expected question, 4 to 5 mark you can expect for the coming exam. Now let us see. You know, sales minus variable cost is called contribution. Less fixed cost is equal to EBIT, earnings before interest and tax. Less interest is equal to earnings before tax. Less tax is equal to earnings after tax. You know the format for sales minus variable cost is equal to contribution minus fixed cost is equal to EBIT minus interest is equal to EBT minus tax is equal to EAT. You know this concept. Less preference dividend, if any, balance is called earnings available to equity shareholders. Earnings available to equity shareholders divided by number of equity shares is called earning per share, EPS, earning per share. For example, earnings available to equity shareholders is equal to 100 lakhs. Earnings available to equity shareholders is equal to 100 lakhs. Number of equity shares is equal to 10 lakhs. Therefore, earning per share comes to how much? Rupees 10. 10 rupees a earning per share. In the sense, what if you are having shares, per share you are entitled to get 10 rupees, your earnings is equal to 10 rupees. Suppose you are having 100 number of shares, 100 into 10 you are entitled to get. Other person having what, 5000 share, 5000 into 10 is entitled to get. That is called earning per share. Now as a company, how many lakhs profit I am having? 100 lakhs profit I am having. Suppose I need money for the purpose of purchasing one machinery to do the business. So I have to invest for the purpose of buying the machine. For that investment, I need 60 lakhs worth of the machinery. In this juncture, option A, I can borrow 60 lakhs loan and I can buy the machinery. Or I am having 100 lakhs rupees in my hand, out of which I can spend and purchase or invest the money to buy the machinery. Therefore, what I want to do, out of 100 lakhs, 60 lakhs I would like to retain for the purpose of purchasing machinery. Remaining 40 lakhs only I would like to give to the shareholders. Even though as a shareholders you are entitled to get 100 lakhs, how much I am ready to pay? Only 40 lakhs. What I am going to do with the 60 lakhs? I want to retain for the purpose of purchasing machinery. So, as a 10 lakh shareholders are there, mean how much you are entitled to get? Now 4 rupees only you will get. Instead of 10 rupees per share, you are eligible to get only 4 rupees. The 10 rupees is called earning per share, EPS, whereas 4 rupees is called dividend per share, DPS. Therefore, dividend per share is equal to DPS is equal to EPS into dividend payout ratio. So it's a derivation with respect to formula. For example, earning per share 10 rupees, we have paid dividend only out of 100 lakhs, 40 lakhs only are paying, ready to pay dividend. Therefore 40%, therefore DPS is equal to rupees 4. So what are the formula for DPS? EPS into dividend payout ratio is equal to DPS. Based on this formula, past exam question, 3 mark questions are there. Find out KE, cost of equity. Now coming back to our original issue. Now you understood what is called EPF and DPS. As a shareholders, we are having fund profit to the company 100 lakhs, but how much I am ready to pay only? 60 lakhs only. So 40 lakhs only I am ready to pay, 60 lakhs I want to earn, I want to retain. That's why the 60 lakhs is called retained earning. Whatever you earned, that I am going to retain as a company, the company. That's why it's called retained earning. How much I am ready to pay? Only 40 lakhs. I would like to pay as a dividend only 40 lakhs. So the 40% is called dividend payout ratio. Out of 100 lakhs, I am paying only 40 lakhs. Therefore, 40% is the dividend payout ratio. 60% is called what? Retained earning. Now, that retained earning, I am going to make use for the purpose of investing as a fund for the purpose of my own business. It may be for the purpose of working capital investment or for the purpose of purchasing fixed asset. I can be in the position to make use of my retained earning. So, suppose the shareholders are going to argue, no, I want the entire 100 lakhs as a dividend. Then, why you are investing money for the purpose of machinery? If you are going to ask, it is again beneficial only because if I am going to pay entire 100 lakhs as a dividend, EPS and DPS one and same, then for the business purpose, I have to purchase machinery, assume I need 60 lakhs, if I am going to borrow 60 lakhs from the other financial institution. In next year, I have to pay interest. If I am going to pay interest, next year profit will come down, then next year dividend will come down. Instead of that, out of this year profit, I am going to retain earning 60 lakhs. I am investing fund and out of machinery, I am going to generate new profit out of new machinery. Then out of the new profit, you will get new profit, extra profit you can get it too. Therefore, shareholders point of view, it's a beneficial only. So, retain earning, it's nothing but what? Instead of borrowing from others, I am going to make use of my own fund, retained fund, as a finance for the purpose of my own business. It's called self-financing. What is it called? Self-financing. So instead of borrowing money from others, my own profit I am retained earning, by way of retained earning, I am using it. That's why it's called self-financing. So the concept of self-financing is called ploughing back of profit. PLOUGHING. BACK, back of PROFIT. So, short notes on plugging back of profit. It's an expected question. It's a concept of self-financing. What are the advantage for the same? First one, I don't need to depend on external source. My own fund I can make use. Dilution of the control, I can be in the position to save. I don't need to what? Control, I don't need to lose. Dilution of the control is can be the position to avoid. But at the same time, I should be very careful. Because just because I'm having profit, just because I want to do some retained earning, it should not lead to overcapitalization. Whatever the fund I require, that only I have to do. It may not should lead to what? Overcapitalization, otherwise window dressing will come. So I should be very careful. And just because I am having profit, I should not invest in non-profitable water sector. So I should be very careful whether return on investment, if I am going to invest the 60 lakhs, return on investment and the cost benefit analysis is worth it for the purpose of investing or not. That is also you have to verify. So the concept of self-financing, plugging back of profit, it's an expected question. Hope you understood the concept. Thank you, students.